They're a powerful couple in Hawaii law enforcement. Honolulu Police Chief Louis Kealoha and his wife Catherine in the prosecutor's office. But they've been dogged by suspicion for more than a year, stemming from several high-profile legal battles and related investigations. Tonight, the Kealohas are speaking out exclusively on KHON2 and telling Always Investigating's Gina Mangieri they have done nothing wrong. Gina?
Joe, a family feud led to a civil lawsuit. The Kealohas won, and a federal criminal case they brought against an uncle ended in a mistrial and allegations of their ethical lapses. Now there's a federal investigation and grand jury looking into corruption. Until now, the police chief and his wife have stayed quiet. But they say the controversies and accusations are now too much to ignore, and they want to set the record straight.
How confident are you that you will be cleared in this federal case?
I would be surprised if anything came out. I am absolutely confident that with these allegations that they're going to be unfounded.
I agree, the same.
But what is at stake, and how did it get the attention of the FBI and a federal grand jury? This federal public defender represented Kathy Kealoha's uncle when the Kealohas accused the uncle in a case that ended in mistrial of stealing their mailbox during a family financial dispute.
After the mistrial, I presented the evidence that I had to the United States Attorney's Office, and I asked them if they believed the information I had gave them warranted a further investigation to dismiss the case against my client with prejudice, which they did, and for them to refer the case to the FBI for criminal investigation, which they did. They could have dropped it, but instead, a special prosecutor was appointed by Attorney General Holder to come into the case to investigate and to proceed before the grand jury, and that's where we are today.
I think what this whole thing is, the same issue is being rehashed in different arenas. You have the federal court, you have the civil trial, you have the ethics, now you have the federal investigation. It's just continuing to be rehashed.
The federal public defender says it's a whole different ballgame than the county ethics investigations or the civil trial that ended in a verdict on the Kealoha side or the uncle's federal mistrial.
It's a very different venue. We're discussing in the grand jury, from what I understand, criminal charges that involve criminal civil rights violations, obstruction charges, false services charges, dishonest services of government workers. There's a lot more going on in the grand jury that involves criminal allegations, which do not go into play in the police commission or the ethics commission.
The Kealohas say they've done nothing wrong and question what's behind the multi-agency inquiries and investigations.
I think this is all about is you have people to promote their own professional and personal agendas to achieve their own goals. This is something everyone wants to hang their hat on and to promote themselves. So it is frustrating, it's really disappointing. In a way to see how this is unfolding.
There are a lot of cases that I've been currently working on that a lot of people are very upset about. And I'm talking about people who are in substantial positions of power within the county.
It seems so unfathomable that so many agencies and individuals would realistically gang up on two people. Mm. What would you say to them?
I think people want to believe so much that the police chief is corrupt and the prosecutor is corrupt that they're willing to do anything, including lie, to make it true.
But should either of them be on the job while this all plays out?
You have to look at what he's doing now and why he's doing the things he does, who he's promoting, the policies that he set in. All these things come into question when you have to look back later as to why did he do it. Did he do it for personal reasons, personal gain, or did he do it for the good of the department?
If an officer is accused of something, they'll often be roped or put on desk duty or that. Now, you're under a cloud of suspicion from the grand jury.
Mm-hmm.
Should you be doing your job every day or stepping aside until it's over?
Well, that's a good question, and here's the answer. The answer to that, I'm no different than any other officer, whether it's in the top administration, with the top brass, or with the officer walking the beat. I'm no different than that, and I don't expect to be treated differently than that. The difference here is that whenever one of our officers are put under investigation or ROPA'd, is that they are served with a complaint. I've never been served with any complaint. Until then, I shouldn't be on ROPA'd, because that's the due process. Serve me with a complaint, allow me to respond to the complaint, and then we can go from there.
The Kealoha has told me a lot of new information about the ethics investigations and the political motivation they think is behind all of this. When could indictments come if they're handed down, and what the Kealohas say they do next? And are the watchdog agencies making moves in the public's best interest while all of this is in limbo? I'm digging into all sides of this as we continue our coverage on the KHON2 News tomorrow. Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News.